One of the things that we breathe out is carbon dioxide. But what does carbon dioxide have to do with fire? Welcome to Corey's Curious Science. In this episode, we'll be exploring what carbon dioxide does when it's added to fire. To do this, you'll need a responsible adult, and we need to first create some carbon dioxide. And we can do that by adding some bicarb soda and some vinegar to a glass jug. So I'm going to put about 1 teaspoon of bicarb soda and a good lug of vinegar, and we'll see what happens. Whoa! You can see that we're getting a lot of bubbles in there, and these are all bubbles of carbon dioxide. But I wonder, what will happen if we add a lit match and put it into the jug? Have a guess, pause the video, and type your guess in the comments below. Are you ready? Here's our lit match. 3, 2, 1. Our match went out when we added it to the jug. Let's try the experiment again. But this time, instead of adding a match to our jug of carbon dioxide, we'll try pouring our carbon dioxide onto a candle. Let's give it a go. Again, we'll add about a teaspoon of bicarb soda, a good lug of vinegar, and we get our bubbles again. And very carefully, we'll pour carbon dioxide into this glass. Now watch what happens when we try pouring the carbon dioxide onto our candle. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1. The candle went out. This is really cool. So it doesn't matter whether we add the fire to our carbon dioxide or the carbon dioxide, we can pour it onto our fire. It still puts the candle out. And I wonder why this is. And how is it that we were able to pour carbon dioxide when it's a gas that we can't even see? Try this experiment for yourself. And when you're ready, check out part 2 of this video to explore the science behind why this happens. Remember to subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Happy sciencing!